Hello everybody, my name is Cameron Brown and a warm welcome to the How to Cameron channel and welcome to another story video. Today's story video though is actually going to be quite insightful, I think, though, because I'm going to be talking about something that I actually do regularly that's very much helped me out. And I feel like making this video is actually going to help a lot of people out, so I want everyone to smash like. I want my ego to be bigger. I'm now helping you guys out. That's how my ego can be enlarged, knowing that I have helped my fans out. So I made two videos, standing up, talking about a past relationship that I had with a girl, and quite frankly, I've never had such a varied response. I had lots of people saying, wow, Cameron, you have a lot of courage, you know, making a video, admitting to your mistakes, and talking about what went wrong. And then I got a lot of people saying to me, oh, you're being a complete prick. You're doing so many things wrong. Pretty much you own outfits at this point. Shut up. I got lots of comments like that, word for word. And I probably shouldn't bring this up, but my own parents were angry at me for making them two videos on this girl. They thought I was bullying her. They thought I was being horrible to her. And I think it just really shows how, like, my parents don't understand my YouTube channel. And quite frankly, I don't care. Like, that's the thing that I don't think a lot of people understand when it comes to my channel. And this goes for people at school, my friends, whatever. I do not give a shit what you think about my channel. I don't care. It's my channel. You've got to realize that every single video I make, I really do think about. I make sure that the video isn't too harsh, and I make sure that the video is acceptable. I know for a fact that knowing how she treated me after we stopped being friends, and knowing what she did wrong as a person to my friend and me in general, because she wasn't perfect, I know for a fact the two videos I made on her were completely fair. Completely fair. There was someone who said, like, it's not fair me talking about her mental issues, i.e. depression, and her, like, eating disorder or something like that. I said she literally had an issue with eating in front of people, which I don't think is particularly private. How's that private? Like, who cares? And then when it came to mental health, I said she was down. I did not say she was depressed. And you've got to realize that I said that for a good reason. I didn't say she was down just to make fun of her. I didn't say she was down to make her vulnerable. I actually mentioned that just because I wanted people to understand why I had my apprehensions with making the two videos on her. I don't think it's wrong me just saying that she was down recently. Like, how's that that bad? It seems like people are very much taking the two videos I made on her completely out of proportion just to be offended. I don't mind criticism. To be fair, that comment that I got, it was a little bit ill-informed, but it was criticism, and it did make me think. So I appreciate the criticism. I always do appreciate criticism. But at the end of the day, if you're going to criticize me, you need to have a good, you know, understanding of everything, I feel. And I think the issue with the two videos that I made, and I definitely think that was an issue, was just how I was still a bit vague. But quite frankly, if I went any more in depth, you know, if I shown messages off, if I actually shown footage or whatever, I feel like it would have just been too much, because at the end of the day, I'm not bothered about her, believe it or not. I got a lot of people saying I'm sorry because she blocked me. But anyway, today I wanted to talk about something nowhere near as controversial. I wanted to talk about meditation and calming down. And I know a lot of people are going to be quick to go, Cameron, you're such a beta male. Shut up. Okay, I'm not a beta male. I'm an alpha male. I'm 6'9". Shut up. Okay, how about that? I'm so tall, my head is actually touching the ceiling at all time. Now, on a serious note, I know people are going to, like, think that this video is completely pathetic and think it's not relatable and think it's on a completely stupid topic, but it's not. That's why I'm making this video, because people have such a bad view on, like, meditation and calming down. And the reason why I know that is because I was exactly the same. I remember I used to make fun of Jade for meditating. I think I said in one of my reaction videos to her that I thought it was daft how she spent lots of time in the morning just meditating, doing meditation when, you know, she woke up so early. I was thinking to myself, wow, you wake up at goddamn 5 and you're spending 30 minutes doing nothing, are you meditating? Actually meditating myself, you know, 30 minutes is a bit over the top, in my opinion. And I still stand by what I said. Like, at the end of the day, if you are waking up at 5, you probably shouldn't spend 30 minutes just meditating, because, like, it's a waste of time at that point. Like, if you're spending 30 minutes on it, I don't think you need to. But pretty much, when it comes to meditation, a lot of YouTube videos about it are made by people who very much are perfect. Like, they try to come across as perfect to their fans. They're not controversial. And, you know, they're doing well in their life. Like, for example, you look at goddamn Jada Jade's channel. She's a vegan. She, you know, is doing really well with her degree, even though she's not doing it yet. Great job. Thanks, brain. Glad I'm making a good video today. You know, she did perfect in her A-levels, perfect in her GCSEs. She cares about the environment. She makes positive videos. She never gets dislikes. People are quick to assume that meditation is associated with being perfect. And that couldn't be any further from the truth. Most people who do meditation are not like that at all. Lots of people who meditate have a bad life. And the reason why they meditate is to calm it down, calm down their life. I've got to mention, leave a like on this video if you knew. What? I need to goddamn meditate. I can't think straight. No, leave a like on this video if you enjoy and find it useful. And subscribe to the channel if you're new today. I'm going to talk about how I got into meditating. Meditating. That doesn't sound right. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. Crap. It don't matter. But I wanted just to talk about how I got into meditation and also why it's actually a lot better than people say it is. And I want to talk about some funny stories regarding it. So I want to firstly mention that I know I've mentioned this a lot. I went through a lot of tough schmit. Like, literally since August to probably, like, halfway through December, my life was bad. Like, really bad. And even now, it's not great. It's not even good. It's just, like, I couldn't deal with it. Pretty much, my point is, if you are struggling, goddamn get help. Just don't keep it alone. Don't keep it a secret. I was so, like, convinced with the idea of being manly, and convinced with the idea of I don't need anyone's help, that I completely driven myself into the dirt. I'm really glad I persevered. Back then, you know, I didn't even think people cared about me. I thought everyone was out to get me. I thought everyone was against me, and I went through a lot of tough times. And, you know, the boxing helped me a lot. That was the biggest thing that helped me through it. And then I started talking to my, you know, ex again, and then we resolved things like that, and she'd forgiven me. And then after that, I was able to grow as a person. And I got better. And that's the thing you got to realize. I don't care how tough of a time you're going through right now. It always gets better. Because a good thing with being right at the bottom is it only goes up. It can't physically get any worse. And because of that, once it starts going up again, you start to feel happy again. And the motivation kicks in. And then you're able to do well. Meditation. A lot of people just presume that meditation is for people who are very perfect in their life, people that assume that it's supernatural, and that's not it at all. So I want to talk about what I do for meditation, meditating. I swear meditation is a word, it just sounds flipping stupid. But every morning when I wake up, I get a glass of water, I drink the water, and then I meditate. It's the first thing I do every morning, and I think of Jade. I think in her morning routine, she literally had a glass of water every morning, and I was thinking to myself, why would you do that? As soon as you do it, like, you don't realize how much better you feel. Like, maybe it's because I eat right before I go to sleep, but when I wake up, like, I'm a bit, not sick, I don't feel ill, I don't feel like I'm working, like, my body's just tired, and the water revitalizes me, guys. Let's all get Fiji water. Woo, Fiji water! Fiji water is overpriced and a waste of money! Well, yeah, pretty much, like, I drink water in the morning, and then I do some meditation. I literally search up meditation on YouTube. I sit back in my chair, and for 10 minutes, I just relax. And here's the thing, I don't know if this is, but I get out of breath so easily. Not in terms of exercise. I don't want anyone to think I'm flipping lazy or fat or anything. I'm not. Like, I get really out of breath for some reason. I'm not good at breathing, okay? I'm sorry. I mean, I don't get out of breath when I do exercise or when I talk or when I, you know, just do general things. It's just when it comes to meditating, I just seem to get out of breath quite easily. So obviously, that adapted though. That got a lot better. I don't really get out of breath anymore. But it used to be quite tough for me to get used to breathing in such an algorithmic way. You know, because normally you just breathe randomly. When you do meditating, you actually focus on it. And it really calms you down. Like, that's the thing with meditating. I did it as a joke, like, one time. And it actually helped me so much. And I wish I learned about it sooner. Like, I know that this video may not be that interesting. I get that this video is not me really saying anything new. But I urge you, if you feel down, if you feel anxious, if you feel depressed, if you feel tired, just meditate. It helps you so much because it makes you think logically. That's the biggest thing. You know, I wish when I had, you know, an eating disorder, I wish when I had anxiety with having a girlfriend and everything, I wish I just meditated. Literally, it would have calmed me the hell down. And it would have made me realize that the issue was not her. The issue was my thought process, my mindset. And it really rationalizes you. It makes you trust yourself, and it also makes you just feel good about yourself. You feel in control. And this is the thing. It crazes me how people are quick to, like, self-harm. And this is coming from someone who actually used to. And I didn't cut myself. I never did anything like that because I didn't want permanent damage. I used to literally punch myself in the head. And I know it sounds daft, because obviously it's quite daft. Just imagine me in the kitchen going, like, yeah, it is daft. And it did improve, like, my strength a little bit, I guess. Like, my bicep grew probably a bit from it. You know, work done and everything. Straining my muscles, strenuous activity, close range quarter punching. What am I on about? But seriously, on a real note, I completely battered myself. It's crazy to me how people are quick to, like, self-harm, to feel in control of their emotions, where you can literally just sit down and relax and do meditating. It's so much easier. And it releases anger. Like, that's the biggest thing. Like, with me, I wasn't just anxious. You know, the anxiety I could kind of get to grips with, because when I was anxious, I still didn't treat people like crap. But the anxiety caused me to have angriness, and I got so angry. Like, my anger levels were over 9,000. That's the fucking worst thing I've said in my life. No, seriously, I was so angry. And, you know, the meditating, it really relaxed me, and it's better than just punching myself at the end of the day. I started it as a joke, and I do it every day. So it does work, and it really rationalizes yourself, and that's the biggest thing you've got to realize. You know, if you're having issues with depression, if you're having issues with anxiety, you've got to realize that it's all in your head. Like, I know it sounds so daft, and you don't realize it until you kind of escape from it for like 10 minutes or whatever. That's how long I spend meditating. You don't realize that it's all in your head until you meditate, until you think about it logically, get a psychiatrist, whatever. Honestly, it was something that really helped me out, and I urge a lot of people just to search meditation on YouTube and try it out once or twice. It really works. A lot of people, though, have a negative opinion on it, because a lot of people are quick to go, yeah, but I would do that instead of exercise. You know, because, I mean, it takes some time. You need mat, like, if you want to do it properly. I do it in bed sometimes. I do it sitting down most of the time on my chair. A lot of people are quick to go, oh, I'm not going to meditate because I'm not doing any exercise. You know, don't burn any calories. I don't want to gain weight. I want to lose weight, whatever. That's what people say normally. But at the end of the day, I feel like meditating, it very much motivates you to do physical exercise. One of the main reasons why I became so avid with boxing was just because the meditating made me relax mentally, and the boxing made me feel good physically. And when you're mentally healthy and physically healthy at the same time, it's phenomenal. For me, it's always been one of the two. You know, I've either been really mentally happy in myself, you know, before I dated Isha and everything, I used to be so mentally happy, but physically not. And then October, you know, after I broke up with her. And I know that I mention the breakup and the relationship a lot, but the reason why I am is because they were the causes of the issue at the end of the day. That's what caused me to have bad mental health. It wasn't her fault. It was just because I was so inexperienced. And it caused me to have, like, a very adverse, you know, effect of the relationship. But physically, you know, I was really, really well off, you know, after our relationship. But mentally, I was destroyed. I know that this video is quite deep. I understand that it's not that funny, but god dang it, I'm just trying to help you guys out. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I will see you guys dabbing on the like button by clicking it, and dabbing on the bell button by clicking it, and subbing by clicking the bell. Crap.